You're welcome. This is a part 10 of student result system. This is ASP.NET C# project. Here we can learn like how to make ASP.NET project with source code. And you can also download this project from our website. In today's video, we'll see like how to modify the records using update statement. Update is a SQL statement. So we have to learn like how to use the update statement. So we already know like how to use the insert, delete, select. The next one is update. So you can download here, cyplix.com/download. You can visit our website and you can download this whole project. So here we are using Visual Studio. And the C# is a language. And backend is a SQL server, right? So if you're not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe. Also, you can like this video and whatever you feel, please write it in the comment. Let me know what you're thinking. And if you have any difficulties when you're writing this project, please communicate with us. So here is the project which we are working, student result system. So these are files which are already created and each session. In today's session, let us understand how to modify the records. Okay, so here you can see that student detail. So we can enter the new records here. But if you want to modify, if the record is already present, if you want to modify, that we want to learn like how to modify the records. So therefore, if data is already there, if I select the particular list number, the data should come over here. We could able to modify that one. Right. So let's see that how to do this. So I just go back to admin main page here. So let me copy this. So better to go to HTML and then you copy from here. So then paste, done. So this is link button 11. So in the properties, select the link button 11. So then bring it down. So change the name, modify student details. So for that you require one more file. So therefore go to add new item. So here admin student modify. There are many ways to modify, but here we'll show you like one way how to do this. So here what are the student details already there, this page, we'll take this page only first. Therefore, you copy the whole HTML content. So we can paste it here. So now if you go to design, you can see that everything is comes. So then here student details entry, student details modification. Okay, so therefore modify. So now we are going to modify this one. Existing student details, we want to modify. And as usual, when you click save, the record has to be modified. Okay, you can say that update. Because already record is there, you need to update. But how do we get the data? So for which student we want to make the changes? That is a requirement. So now here what we can do is, okay, I'll take out this. So you can have one more drop down list. So where you can have a register number. So if you select the register number, and that register number details has to come here. Or else we can use the text box itself. Here you need to type the register number, and we can put a one more button here. If I click the button, the detail has to come. Okay, so that may be easier. So therefore what you can do is we can go to this button and then format. So here you can say display. So after entering the register number, if I click display, so it should display all the details here. So therefore you double click here, there's a button 3 click, and here also you need to update. So therefore double click, it will be there. Right, so now student, so what are the code already written? That same code will do the job. So therefore you need to copy that this two anyway is required in every page. Paste. Connection string also is required, so we can copy the connection string and then we can paste it here. Done. So then modify. Okay, so therefore you can copy this. So this is a button one click. Okay, so you can keep it here first. So this is not required now. I can. Okay, so this we'll use in the button 3 click. So you need to use a select statement. So here how it works. So when you enter the register number in the text box 1, if you click the button, so we need to read the values from the student table, and what are the values we read, and then we need to send back to the text boxes. So here it should be text boxes, therefore I can take out this. So now we can write here text box 2. So 1, we only enter the register number that is already there. Text, you don't need to change. That is equal to. So TR1 will have all the columns. So all the columns will be there here. The first one is the register number. Next is the student name. So text box 2 is the student name. Therefore, we'll say TR1 of. So this index starts from the 0. Therefore, it is 1. Dot to string. So 0 means register number, because which table it is? This is a student table. So register number is 0. DR1 of 0 is a register number. DR1 of 1 is the student name. That we're going to transfer to the text box 2. So same for rest of the text box also. We can copy this. This 3, 4, 5. So now this is a text box 3, there is address, 4 mobile number, 5 email ID. So correspondingly, this address 2, mobile number 3, email ID 4. So course we are not changing now, so course will be as it is, okay. Otherwise you need to select the course. So instead of that, what you can do is, okay. So drop down, list 1.text. So that is equal to DR5. This works. Let me check. Okay. DR5.toText. Fine. Now go to admin main. Link that file. So now this is admin main. So now this is student modify. So here it is. First one you need to select. That is a AXPX. Student modify AXPX. Okay, save. So come back to main page. Press enter key. So here you can see the student modify. Okay. Modify student details. Click here. Okay, fine. Everything is comes. So now you can type BCA101 display. Fine. So you can see that all the details will come back. Now this is the BCA. Here it should be BCA. So therefore what I do, I say BCA. And then if I click update, everything should be updated. Okay. So now what code you have to write in the update? So you have to come back. This is modify. So instead of insert, now we need to use update. Update. Student table. So values is not required. So instead of that, you have to say set. So now the student name that is equal to text box 2. 1 is a register number. Okay, I'll delete 1. So student name is equal to text box 2. Then yes, ADD. That is equal to text box 3, comma, mobile number, that is equal to text box 4. Next, email, that is equal to text box 5. then this is course name, that is equal to drop down list one, and your password will be as it is. Okay, then you have to give the where condition, that is important. If there is no where condition, then all the records will be changed to these values. Therefore, where reg number, that is equal to text box one. Okay, so paste. Okay, so text box one has to come. So where so this is a text box 1 dot text, where register number is equal to text box 1 dot text. Now this particular student has to be updated. Record updated successfully. So then we clear all the text box. Okay, so now we'll go back here, display, change the mobile number to 111. So this is Ravish Gmail. So change to iplix.com. So then initial Ravish M. Fine. Now if I click here, I'll change to BCA. Update. Record saved successfully. Now I'll check again. So this is BCA101. Display. You can see that mobile number is changed. So email ID is changed. M is added. So all changes done. So now if I go to student list here, I can see that new details. So this is how we can modify the records. So when I click modify, so this is BCA1001 display, we can do this. Or else we can also show the list here. If I select anyone, then the details has to come here, and that also can modify, because here you can see completely. That's how we done for delete, no? So same way you can do it for here also. For that, what you have to do is, so here student delete, so here it is. So we need to copy this whole code along with this SQL data source. Okay. And so form is not required. Okay, so you need to copy grid view from the grid view to data source. If data source is somewhere else, you need to copy separately. Okay, so this is a modify, student modify, here it is. So then go to source. So before the form, so make some space here. And there is one more problem. SQL data source 1 is already there. So it's supposed to be 2 now. So here it is 2. But it should be link where we are linking. There also it should be 2. So grid view, you can check it out here. So here is the data source 1. Okay, change to 2 now. So here automatically it will change. So therefore you need to take care. And also there is an event here. So we need to create that event. And then now, what we can do is, so we can take to right side. Okay, so all right. So here you can double click. So we'll take to this selected index changed. So here, so this again required. So therefore you can copy all these things. So this is a selected index changed. So we're copied. So here you can ask for, do you want to modify this record? Anyway, we'll modify later, so therefore no need. So I'll just delete this. Okay, so this is not required. So again, I want to delete this. Okay, all this is not required. Only thing is, we need to transfer the which register number you want. Okay, that is transferred. Now, what about this code? This we need to call it again. Otherwise, we need to copy this and paste. Except the register number that we need to change. So therefore we paste here. Now V1. So here V1 has to come, because the value is there in the V1. Fine. So save. Then So now you can see that I'll going to select this. So now you can see all the data will come back, but even register number should come. So therefore we have to go there, and then we can add this one more line. So here it's text box 1, this is 0, because your table index number, column number start from 0. Now if I come back and if I click select, so you can see that all the details is coming. Then we can make the changes and then click update. So this is how we can do the update. So hope you understand the concept. So please try this. You have to try yourself, then only you know like what are the problems. Definitely there are some errors, so don't worry. So you need to understand why error is coming, then you need to figure it out and you need to solve that error. Once you solve, you get an experience. That experience will count in your job, because easily you can get the job when you have an experience. Therefore sit at home and then keep practice, keep learn, and once you complete, probably you can add this project into your resume. That is advantage. So meanwhile, please come back to our channel and then save, subscribe, also write comments, and then share our videos with your friends and watch other videos, and then learn how to make other projects too. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much.